I'd like to thank Mike for surrendering his music stand. Okay, this one's called Polka, if it doesn't fall over. Collapso. What? Oh, okay. The first song, Headphones, the music was written by the Incredible Casuals. And they perform it on the record called Lyrics by Ernest Noyes Brookings, which is available practically nowhere. And this one is by Brave Combo, who all they do is polkas. So when they were given their choice of an Ernie Brookings poem, they picked the one called Polka. Sometimes they do a mazurka or a Scottish just for a change of pace, but generally it's polkas. So pretend this is an accordion adillo. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lyrics will note that one verse was omitted from the typeset copy. obviously they weren't doing using a CD system.
What?
Inside joke.
Okay, I'll play the one I know I'm gonna mess up. This one's called Dinosaurs. It was originally recorded by Min and Volt. And in fact, they used to do it before there was even an idea of doing the Ernie Brookings record. They used to do it live back when Ernie was still alive. I think he actually heard them do it, so one of the few. I think the Jad Fairtune killed them, actually. After I get through this one, the second one's my cheese. Gigantic, four-footed reptile mammal appears suddenly from Stone Cave. Are related to Stone Ages, except camel have still vision to view waves. With underbodies frequently wrangle, they shuffle and wriggle and clash. Later, a tenuous wrangle with a snort like a rash. As nomads of the Mesozoic age, they wander over the crust of the earth. Their actions are all the rage, do not recall their dates of birth. And climbed onto high terrain, gazed at the vast scene below. Have but a small brain in which they partially think, hello. Said one quadruped to brother, have you projections on your back? Yes, it will not smother, but it keeps me on the track.
Fingers and claws all over the earth. Baby flies with no nutrition. Mother loves it to breathe in laws because it's her intuition. Mother feeds baby from her.
This one is called William Shakespeare. It's by Ray Mason. He didn't make it tonight. I was hoping Kurt would show up with this one, since Kurt was intimately involved with its production. And I don't do Kurt's tune, so This is as close as I can get. Okay. William Shakespeare by Ray Mason. Lyrics, once again, by Ernest Noyes Brookings. And also, if you have the album, this one isn't on the album. It's one of the cassette bonus tracks.
William Shakespeare, William Shakespeare, Shakespeare, an author of manuscripts and books. One of his subjects, delirious crude. While writing, used a notebook and pen. Wrote as thoughts entered his mind. At times his stories included many men. He was always joyous and kind.
Thank you.
on a steamboat crossing Lake Champlain to make sure that we are in want. No tension on a railroad train.
In the United States, private commercial barber costs not
bottom pennies in seats, 50 cents. There are many ships in the harbor. Sailors make the barber tents. On ships await drastic command. Haircuts and a plate and a robe. Strike up a nautical band. If a wedding, locate the crew. Ships await drastic command. Haircuts in a blaze and a roam. Strike up a nautical band. If a wedding, locate the groom.
Or a little head.
try hot dog again correctly this time. Yeah. And the other thing I'll say about this song is the food in Peru and Ecuador was by and large very good, although it was very meat intensive. And it got to the point where on the boat in the Galapagos Islands they were serving us hot dogs for breakfast. So this is dedicated to Flaco, who was our cook. Hot dog cooked Frankfurter in red, Rolo cooked till down in a flaming wood fire. The taste is good, not all in the shoe, so it's always fresh, never a messy mile. One of me through my hot dog has no tail, the skin is tight and closes back me. Ship's guardrail or anticipate having external feet. In a country home of the hot dog done, one daughter, yes, am awaiting the taste. They return from cooking one by one, always in patience, never in haste. Picnic hot dog special food, how the vegetables ever refreshed. All were happy in a good mood, with their smiles all flourished. After this, Judas and Natasha, don't forget to tip your waitress.